The city of Rotterdam is located in the west of the Netherlands, 20 kilometers from the coast of the North Sea. Together with The Hague, Utrecht, Amsterdam and the surrounding areas, it makes up the very important and dense region of Randstad. The city lies on both sides of the Nieuwe Maas River, which is a northern distributary of the Rhine River, the second largest in Europe. Rotterdam is the largest European port, and certainly its most important. Some of the highlights of the city are the Euromas, the Erasmus Bridge, and the so-called World Museum. Through the years, Rotterdam has developed a multicultural ambiance. The history of Rotterdam begins in the 13th century, though its settlement dates from at least the 10th century. Already in the 1300s, Rotterdam played a role as a local transshipment center for trade between the Netherlands, England, and Germany, contributing to the growth of its economy and importance in the region. Over the centuries, Rotterdam developed further in terms of economic strength and in population. The port eventually outgrew the city boundaries and had to be displaced further and further away from the city to accommodate its growth. The city was almost fully destroyed during the Second World War. It has gradually been rebuilt. The economic importance of the port has not diminished either. Today, though Rotterdam is known synonymously as a port, it also has been recognized by its residents, tourists, and the global community as a vibrant and livable city, receiving numerous awards for its urban planning and architecture. Freights heading to Europe from the rest of the world, primarily in containers, are redistributed to the rest of the Netherlands and Europe via the port. The port provides good access and intermodal connections via rail, its extensive inland waterways, short-distance shipping, and road. Especially for the destinations within the Netherlands, trucks are indispensable for the last-mile deliveries of goods from and to the port. By moving the port away from the city center, traffic that does not need to enter the city can simply be diverted via the other routes available. But the traffic that nevertheless needs to enter the city are subject to restrictions in order to reduce its impact on the city. Freight traffic, though vital for its economy, needs to be managed well to reduce congestion, air pollution, and carbon dioxide emissions. The role of urban freight transport planning will need to account for these challenges to ensure a lively, economically competitive, and fun city.